Okay, guys, is this working? Safe? You there?
Dire team ban. Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Okay, it should be working now, I guess.
Oh yeah, I hear you now. What's up?
Okay, we're good to go. So, hi everyone! We're finally, after some delay, starting to cast this. This is the female C League that we're gonna cast today. Rock and roll against Pak Ganner. And it's gonna be the best of two. I'm here with Safesin, and we're both Dota Fire members and editors. And hopefully this will be fun.
Dire team's turn to pick. Oga Magi!
And it starts just like
good.
TI.
This is good. Yeah, well, I mean, they banned Centaur, which is not like TI at all.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, and Death Prophet first banned, Lifestealer and Invoker. Okay, then.
5 seconds remaining.
We don't
it's
know
interesting
the...
that Prophet and Centaur are the first bands.
Reserve time.
Yeah, we
I
don't
have to
really
wonder
know.
If, they did research on Pack and Earn before this.
Exactly. We don't know the teams, that's important to say, at all. This is a new league that started now, and the teams, if I'm not mistaken, were composed over the last 2 weeks or something like that. So we won't be able to go into that. Okay, a Void and a Lion to go with. Interesting. That's, yeah, what's gonna be the follow-up for this?
Right? I mean, it's not the follow-up to the Void that I would have expected. You know, I was expecting something like maybe a Elder Titan or a Wyvern or something.
Yeah.
But, you know, Lion's not bad. Lion's a pretty solid support, and if they have a decent Lion player, it's probably worth... It's arguably worth a first phase pick, especially if they're sort of known for their Lion.
Yeah, I agree. It's still a flexible support, so... Another flexible support, Witch Doctor works well in every situation, I guess? It offers some
important thing
sustain.
Is, unless the Faceless Void gets a... Yeah, it offers some sustain. Unless the Faceless Void gets a BKB, theoretically you can also try and get the stun inside of Chronosphere to stop it from doing much. And Death Ward is also a decent response to Chronosphere, though I personally like pairing the Witch Doctor with the Void.
Yeah, me too.
As opposed to against it.
Radiant teams turn to ban.
I would say also that they're keeping it kind of open for the laning stage for now, because the Void can be safe or offlane. So we don't know yet, we'll see. Mirana is out
right.
for now,
yeah.
Even though she was nerfed. Good job, I shrugged there.
Yeah, she wasn't nerfed that hard.
Yeah, I think so also. I think it's okay, but I've heard some people saying that it's the kind of thing that makes her not be peak phase material anymore, you know? Just the first phase. So I'm not sure.
No, I think that's about accurate. I think it's enough to make her not first phase ban pick anymore, but it's not like she got nerfed to the ground. Just, that little extra bit of ridiculous damage at the edge.
Yeah, that disappeared. Radiant team bang. Okay, interesting. So now no disruptor and no axe. They are worried with initiation, I would say, because Centaur and Axe both are very similar and they are both banned. I wouldn't expect them necessarily.
Right.
So.
Well, absolutely. I mean, especially when paired with the Witch Doctor, right? I mean, the Witch Doctor's not going to be sort of your offlaner or your initiator or anything. That's like your big source of teamfight damage.
Yeah, exactly.
So if you have any sort of reliable lockdown, you have to be careful about that.
Yep. No Slark also?
Alright. People don't like Slark. I know that. I know you don't like that.
I know people don't. I'm here to make that idea go away one day. 5 seconds remaining. I will fight for that. Also, it was not touched on this patch yet, so let's hope it hits. It'll be kept that way. You see, the my point is basically is only OP in low level games because people don't know how to ward and position properly. Because otherwise, it has the same weaknesses and strengths of other heroes. It needs to initiate, it needs to go invisible, and if you avoid that, then you're okay to go, I would say.
I mean, yeah, that's absolutely true, but you forget that the majority of games are low-level games.
Yeah, so I know. But
people hate Slark.
Yeah, exactly. Okay, so we have the follow-up that we were talking about.
Yeah.
We're expecting great things from
Bubble. It's an interesting follow-up. I mean, the thing about running the Void Lich, while it sounds really awesome on paper, is that if you don't get a multi-man Chronosphere, then your Chain Frost still kind of does nothing.
Yeah, exactly.
I mean, it's certainly not bad by any stretch, and Lich is just strong support in general. Helps starve out the enemy lanes, whichever one he goes to.
Yeah, I totally agree with you.
But it's just a little harder to execute than something like your Void Elder Titan, right?
Yeah, exactly. Basically, you have no plan B. Either you do a good chrono and you win a team fight, or you don't do anything. And you're very reliant also on the chrono cooldown. But on the other hand, the good news is...
Which did just get nerfed as well in the last patch.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. Well, but they have a Tide Hunter on Pack Gunner, so I will guess that they also will be a bit reliant on that cooldown.
Mm-hmm. You're going full Wombo combo here.
Yes, now Queen of Pain for mid, we're expecting. Another big team fight, another follow-up for Chrono. But once again, if you don't have Chrono, it can be complicated. And this is amazing music to entertain you guys. While the picks are going on. Reserve
time.
Not anymore.
No, that was my alarm clock because.
Oh yeah.
Going back to bed before this.
Yeah, we're casting from different times, so don't worry if we sound either too lazy or too sleepy or something like that, because it's a sea tournament and we're in Europe and America, so this is very international.
Oh, yeah, absolutely, it's great. Ugh.
Okay, especially if Miracle enters the scene. There is Templar Assassin for mid. So are we going to see Queen of Pain, Templar Assassin?
What's that called? TA Miracle.
What do you think of this matchup, by the way?
TA Miracle. I think it's interesting. It's not the best matchup for the Templar Assassin, I don't think. Just because the Stifling Dagger is pretty good at taking off the Refraction charges.
Yeah, exactly.
But we've seen this match done successfully before, right? It usually depends on how well the Templar Assassin can harass using the Psyblades, and just not get sort of completely burst down. The fact that you can see the Refraction charges now, when you're on the enemy team, it does make it very easy for the Queen of Pain to gauge whether she can jump forward and try to get a kill or not.
Yeah, totally.
But, you know, it's... not completely one-sided.
It's still strange also because they have a Lich which has Frost Armor, so I'm guessing this Templar Assassin won't also be doing as much as she could normally, right? Because she's very powerful against low armor, and she usually goes for the Dazzle.
Absolutely. 10 seconds remaining. Right, no, absolutely. Yeah, the nice thing, even though they do have the armor, is that the Templar Assassin can clear out the Ancient Stacks if they do that sort of thing. Reserve time.
Yeah, also Tide Hunter, so...
I don't actually know if they're going to do that sort of thing.
Yeah, we'll see.
You know.
Yeah, I'm interested in how they are going to laning this, because apparently they're both missing this, I would say, the safe laner? Assuming this Void is offlane. And they banned the drow?
The nice thing about rock and roll's sort of draft... Right, the nice thing about rock and roll's draft is that they do sort of have that laning flexibility right now. You look at Pac and Aaron and you know they're looking for a safe laner, right? Rock and roll, it's still a little up in the air, right?
Yeah, we need something more. Yeah, the anti-mage is banned, so... Radiant team's turn to pick. We're looking at exactly that kind of thing.
I don't know if that's necessarily the best ban. There aren't really a lot of good mana void targets, unless they're planning on picking up, like, OD or something.
Yeah, what can they run here on the safe lane, I'm guessing? There's quite some strong heroes that have been banned already, though. How would, for instance, a Jugger fare against this lineup? I'm not sure.
It's not bad. I mean, Juggernaut does have the invulnerability during Chronosphere.
Yeah.
So he can, if he's not caught inside the Chronosphere, he can still attack inside of it. It's good against the Lion as well. You can probably spin to try and get out of those combos.
Even for Rock and
Roll. If the Lion gets a Blink Dagger, you don't really have a chance.
Yeah, exactly. And from Rock and Roll, even also, if you would imagine him on the other team, he can also use his. Ulti during Chrono, it can also be invulnerable and try to evade Tidehunter with that. It has his little Bicky B,
right.
Like I like to call it. It's actually could be good for both, maybe.
10 seconds remaining.
Who else do you think would be a good pick?
I don't know if Juggernaut is.
Okay, we go all in.
Oscar comes out from Pac and Aaron.
Wild Oscar appears.
Well, that is going to be interesting.
Yeah, he has a Witch Doctor, which is kind of sustain, I guess, but it's not an IO, it's not an Oracle, it's not Dazzle. So I'm not very much sure about this. 10 seconds remaining. He has very strong...
none of those heroes were banned out either.
But the thing is, he has high magic resistance, right? And we're talking about a lot of magical damage on rock and roll sides.
Well, but they also have the Queen of Pain, and keep in mind the Queen of Pain ultimate does now pure
damage.
Yeah,
pure damage,
so...
yeah.
Queen of Pain is actually not bad against the Huskar.
Seconds remaining.
That Sonic Wave can just sort of completely wreck.
Another... another surprise. The Blue Puss. Interesting pick.
Let's pause. I'm sure they'll be back.
There we go.
Yeah, and we have an interesting last pick in the form of Phantom Monster.
Who could turn away from this? 5 seconds remaining.
They don't really have ways of dealing with him.
Yeah, I actually like the Phantom Lancer here.
Yeah, me too.
I do like the Phantom Lancer here, actually. Also great against TA. It's good against Huskar, too, just because, you know, you can disorient him. You can make sure that he can't get too many stacks. I don't believe that you can get rid of the Burning Spear stacks with Doppelwalk, or Doppelganger.
Yeah.
Maybe. I don't know. Ward's coming out here. That is going to be the offlane Void. That makes sense. Alright, we got Khaleesi.
Asking for tangos?
Asking for standard stuff.
Is there gonna be some rune action? There's a smoke on the Lion.
Yeah.
And
smoke
there are
the Lion
wards.
Not used as of yet.
30 seconds to back.
Where are the wards?
Wards on the Phantom Lion?
Like, who gave the offlane a reward to JSDN? Khaleesi's down here. I'm gonna see some maybe. I don't think there's going to be any rune scuffling. I think they're just going to let it go both ways.
Yeah, that's probably the best to do in this situation. I wonder if this Tidehunter is going to be able to stay in lane. We usually see all these Tidehunters with that amazing jungle item that I like to call the Hand of the Jungle. And this one didn't go for that, so...
Yeah. Not go for Hand of the Jungle.
Yeah.
Absolutely. All right, so we've got a decent ward here.
None of them went out from for that,
rock
actually.
And roll.
Yeah, it's...
None of them went for what? None of them went for Hand of the Jungle. All right, good ward here blocking the, well,
he sees it, though, ward. Probably, because he was there, so it should be relatively easy to deward.
It sees it, but it doesn't see a whole lot else.
No, I mean the lion saw him put it up, so it will take a time to have money for sentries, though, I'm guessing. What do you think of this sentries, Queen though. Of Pain
Wait, so this is a...
safe lane for rock?
That is interesting. It's not how I was expecting them to run it. Well, I guess the PL is actually very good against the Templar Assassin mid as well. Well, I don't know. Actually, I don't. It's necessarily the best. But we see 33 going in on scene. Scene's already dropping somewhat low from this.
Yeah. We have our.
But a defensive tri-lane for a Huskar over here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Defending the Huskar against the Void.
Running a defensive tri-lane against a Lich is actually pretty terrifying, perfectly honest.
Yeah.
Ooh, that's a nice ward spot. Yeah. This Templar Assassin is actually carrying a ward and a sentry. Has not used either of them.
Yeah, she's waiting probably, I'm
She has a bottle already, though. Look at the net worth. You know, everything's pretty standard.
Yeah, the both right mids now. Are ahead.
This
offlaners are getting a pawn, though. So.
Mm-hmm.
They're not being zoned out.
If you look at the last hits, 33 is completely demolishing scene in lane right now. 11-1, he actually just got rid of scene's ward as well. So that's an extra 100 gold going the way of the Phantom Lancer. He's gonna... doing nicely.
Yeah, it was interesting that they decided to put him here.
Well.
This way they are protecting the Queen of Pain actually from the bad possible matchup.
Mm-hmm.
She's farming completely free.
About the matchup. Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, there's no Arras.
I kind of thought that the... there's a DC coming out from JSDN. We're gonna pause. Right. Like, the thing about the matchup is that I kind of did favor the Queen of Pain matchup against the Templar Assassin.
Yeah.
And so, you know, I mean, this matchup also works, I think. But it's just, yeah, it's not what we were expecting.
How's the Huskar doing, on the other hand?
Now Lich is paused.
This Huskar is also doing fine. Huskar? Seems to be going fine, although he's going to be a bit starved on XP if this tri-lane doesn't work. They should probably try to rotate a bit more.
I mean, Rock and Roll is securing themselves a pretty huge advantage right now. You have the Lich, who is denying experience from a tri-lane. You've got Huskar, is the most farmed person on Pat Ganarn's team at 8-2. This Phantom Lancer in the mid lane is 17-2. You know.
Yeah, it's going pretty well.
Things
also,
well.
Pretty standard, no rotation lanes.
Mm-hmm. No rotations as of yet.
Interestingly enough,
see this ogre start to rotate a little more once he gets another level.
Yeah, I think
maybe not. You never know.
The ogre and Witch Doctor are a pretty strong duo if they want to do something, but they will probably be. I don't know, they will know that they went away, so... Also, who can they really gank, actually?
Yeah. Right, well, I mean, it's an ogre and a witch doctor, they can gank pretty much anybody they want, but I don't know if you can afford to leave the Huskar alone against the Lich Void.
Yeah. This Tidehunter is
going
in for...
on the Void. Maledict is gonna tick down a little bit, but he's
yeah,
gonna be fine.
Yeah, that's fine. Time walk, OP. Don't nerf, please.
Yeah. I mean, something we haven't talked about, actually, is the Burning Spears sort of Maledict combo. Right? Burning Spears and Maledict both won't get taken off by time walk, and so it's actually not a bad counter to the Void.
Yeah, and that's why he has a point in it, I guess. Opposed to the normal
I'm going to see Piglex rotate mid, deny some creeps for 33, and head right back to the offline.
Yeah, this Tidehunter is starting to fall off a bit because he's sitting completely back, so and not doing anything. So and he has a weird choice of items because he went for a bracer, which is not very common.
Yeah, without iron.
And some action mid.
Oh, scene is getting gone on in the mid lane. Hey, I see it.
They have no vision though, so it should be fine.
Pinging for help. Very desperately pinging for help.
Yeah, but without vision, there's nothing he can do. Portwood needs to rotate.
There's nothing he needs to do.
Yeah,
right?
Exactly. She's not getting anything
JSTN's
done.
JSTN's going in. Wow. JSTN actually got Catherine and Tong so low. Oh, we're getting seen going on and melding again. No vision. 33's going to be patient about this. Oh, Scene's gonna make a run for it.
This is the most interesting chase we've seen lately. Many pings coming out.
Oh god, this is amazing.
There's help.
TP coming in from the Ogre Magi. Here we go. There's the.
I'm not sure about this though because she's very low, but.
Refraction stuns the wrong creep. 33 is gonna go and then back up because the Witch Doctor's coming in. Oh, that lucky bounce though.
Yeah, she will be fine.
We're gonna give Scene a salve, and she's gonna be fine. Yeah.
Askar is left alone, has his urn, boots. Might need to be a bit more careful now.
Not doing bad. Well, Askar is keeping pace with the Queen of Pain. The problem is that this Phantom Lancer is 32 and 4.
Yeah.
To
XP wise,
13 and 0.
Also ahead. I would say the static lane is completely going in favor of rock and roll. But that Askar, when he comes online, that will be a problem, so. Unless they go for him before that happens.
I'm gonna pause again.
He's sitting now at level 5. With some decent chunk of gold. I wonder if he's going armlet first.
This Askar?
Yeah.
Maybe. I think that's probably what you expect coming out of a Huskar. 33 putting decent pressure in on the mid lane.
The supports are now starting to rotate on the part of Puck, but they're not exactly doing anything yet.
Ogre's still level 3.
Witch Doctor level 2.
Witch Doctor's still only level 2.
That is really gonna hurt them.
Really experienced start. Yeah, they have really experienced starved Pat Ganaren. They really have. This Tidehunter, I mean, this Tidehunter is level 5, but it's 7 minutes into the game, right?
Yeah.
This Void is keeping pace with them, as well as this Lich, right?
Yeah, exactly.
So you look here, Lion's level 4. So yeah. All of the supports are outpacing. And we're gonna see a rotation under the mid lane onto 33. But no, nothing will come of it.
Guys, we want some blood, please. You know what I would say, right?
I know what you would say.
Stop being wusses and go!
We're not
go
gonna
for
say
it.
What you would...
Oh, we're gonna say.
That's not what you'd say.
Okay, well, there's a Queen of Pain that's going
Catherine
for the rune.
He's going to break it. He does have Blink available in 5 seconds.
She's
fine. Gonna be fine.
Yeah.
Secured the rune for Scene is gonna be important, considering how badly she's losing it. We're gonna see a rotation down under the Huskar here.
Yeah.
Think.
They need something.
33's thinking about it.
They need to do something about this Huskar, because he's gonna have his armlets soon if he's left unchecked. Then they can get back this network advantage that they got. Dire's middle
tower isn't going to last. And right now, if you look, all three cores on the side of
heads.
Rock and Roll are outfarming the cards.
Yeah, they are. Yeah. They're doing just fine. I wonder what the Void is going for also in this game. For his build. an offlaner. Vara is a lot, usually.
Probably Blink Dagger?
Yeah, I would say something like Blink Dagger.
Usually your...
Also, some go for Vlad's first. I don't know. Okay, they spotted the wards.
Go in on the scene in the mid lane again.
He has help, though.
Rotation going in on to scene. The Lich comes in. Oh! Scene might get her. Nope. 33 is going to be just fine. Scene doesn't want to go under tower. Pig Lex is sticking around.
Yeah, if...
33 does get forced back to base, though.
It's complicated if she gets seen here, though. She can just die immediately. There's a Shane Frost on the Lich now.
We're going to have another one of these,
standoffs.
Alone. She can block like one.
Yeah, she's fine again.
And Scene's fine again.
Yeah, the Void is going for the Headress first.
Oh, Mechanism Void. Interesting.
No, not necessarily also,
no,
right?
No, wait, it's Vlad's.
Yeah, well, it should be Vlad's. We hope so, at least. Because, yeah.
We hope it's Vlad's. So this is Mech Void. This will be a very interesting game indeed.
The Queen of Pain is rotating now. She's level 7. She has her face boots ready to go. But there's an ogre. Pretty sure he spotted
her. 2, 1, 3. Pretty standard build. Well, that ward spotted her at the very least. They are still going to go on to Bacon here.
Witchstalker. First blood.
That's first blood. Nikki's getting gone on as well. I think she's going to die too. Scene coming in as well. Stun is not quite on the mark from the lion. Tidehunter is going to come in.
No Ravage. No Ravage opportunity because he was gone on. So 2-0 for Rock and Roll, and they consolidate a bit more their already had. Askar is still peacefully farming though.
He does have the Helm of Iron Will toward that armlet. I don't know if they're too worried about this, though.
Yeah, it depends.
I don't feel like this is one of those games where a Huskar can just spiral out of control.
Yeah, they're probably just consolidating this lead and they can just roll with it. As long as the Queen of Pain is doing okay also. But she's not... I'm not sure what she's going for, though. She's saving a bit of gold. Level 8, second in network, she should be fine.
She should be fine unless she's saving for Blink Dagger.
Another thing we hope it's not happening.
Yeah, you never know.
Meanwhile, the supports are pretty passive this game indeed. They are not ganking, they're just going around trying to get their levels.
Which they are still struggling with. Both the Ogre and the Witch Doctor are level 4.
Yeah.
While everybody on the side top lane, Scream of Pain takes out JSDN. Scene comes in trying to help, not quite soon enough, and 33 is just going to work on her.
This Phantom Lancer pick is really working out against
she's
her.
She's just gonna go invisible. Oh. That Scream of Pain. They know where she is, but be supporting coming. Oh, and bottom lane, Faceless Void takes out the Huskar. Bacon's getting double gone on kill. As well. Witch Doctor is going to die. It's a double kill for the Void. Radiant's top tower is under
attack. Good rotation from Phantom Lancer. Top.
Yeah.
Let's see some push now coming out.
Yeah, that was really nice, actually. Like, he knew that there was nothing else to be done on scene in the top lane, so he immediately rotated down to the bottom lane.
Exactly.
Back in there and wouldn't have seen that coming.
They weren't expecting it because it was just in a bad spot. And then suddenly there's the tower gone. This network is looking way better. Yep. Way better. Dire's middle tower is under
attack. Let's look at the graph. We're gonna see solid 5,000 gold lead coming out from Rock and Roll. 5,000 experience lead too, so it's not too bad.
They're gonna contest mid? No, it's not, but we'll see. Okay,
they
managed to
mid lane. Oh, they got the
deny. Yeah. Even if pain is out though, and she's going for the axe first. Interesting. This bounces though.
Khaleesi diving in onto the lion, but 33 is gonna go immediately for the witch doctor. He's gonna go down. Finger of death, comes out onto the Huskar. Lion does fall. The scene may fall next. Can he get the meld off in time?
No.
No.
So it's a 3-for-1 and another tower that goes down. Rock and roll is rock and rolling, I would say.
Absolutely.
This void is has the Morbid
on the top
mask
lane,
now?
Though.
Yeah, they're pushing in. They took the tower.
Morbid mask.
Yeah, it keeps doing his
Morbid mask. Lads, right? On the top lane, though, Ak and Aaron do get the top tower. So there's some manner of trade going out here.
Still, like you said, it's a bad sign when all the three cores are ahead. And Phantom Lancer is starting to work now on his defusal.
Right.
Vision wise, they do also have very good vision. There's these two wards on the top lane that are gonna help them push next. Mm-hmm. They don't have anything on the bottom, but they took tier one, so. Yeah, so they're exactly they're following this plan of they assert vision in a certain place, then they get together and they push. And they have very strong team fight now. They have everything up or almost. The Void needs mana though, it doesn't have enough mana. Okay, they are bottling him now. They will have enough mana for Chrono. No finger, but there's the Shane Frost.
They're pushing this early game advantage so much. Like, if you look at the Witch Doctor, they still don't have Death Ward up. It's 16 minutes into the game.
Yeah, the supports really should have rotated more. Okay, they are pushing into the smoke. Okay, Pak smoked behind the tower. Maybe intending on going. Okay, they are going in. There's Chrono, and there's Ravage.
And the Witch Doctor disconnects, actually.
Oh, that is not gonna be good.
Ooh.
Also, we're kind of seeing the lack of follow-up from the Tidehunter Ravage, which is also a problem. Is Ravage kind of stopped a bit, Void?
Yeah.
But not, it was not enough.
Yeah.
He's probably
Look
gonna
at that.
Lose his life now, too. Unless the Witch Doctor manages to save him with his paralyzing cask, which I'm not sure of. They are pursuing.
I think the Tidehunter will be fine and the Witch Doctor will go down. Unless the Tidehunter goes back in, then yeah, he's dead.
Yeah,
he's
walking away.
Yes?
This Bracer being.
Look at that.
Yeah, value. Meanwhile, there's a TA trying to get something on the bottom lane and she has a Blink Dagger on. Going for the Blink instead of the Dazzle first.
Radiant's top tower has looked. Yeah, it's pretty standard, I think.
Not sure if
all
it's what she needs
doesn't
to
do anything if you can't catch up to people.
Yeah, that's true. Not sure if this is gonna help her catch up now though, because she's very far behind, and the blink doesn't help you farm that much, considering you could have a dazzle. But well, we'll see. They keep grouping also. They keep grouping up, and they are found the leech.
Dawn is going in onto Piglex. Piglex is dead. Here.
Good pick up for Huskar. Gonna help. They also pinged out the ward. They see the vision, the deep vision that they had there. So now they are in a bad spot actually, because they don't have vision anywhere, rock and roll. Lost all the vision that they had up. But they did get to the towers.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
Pak is not gonna feel very safe going around the map with no towers either.
Bacon finally picking up her level 6.
And Queen of Pain. This Queen of Pain should
she
be getting her.
Skill like stats or something.
Who? Maybe she.
I'm looking at the Witch Doctor.
Let's see.
Hasn't skilled her ultimate yet.
Oh, it's on now. It was just saving the point, I guess.
Oh, okay.
Ah, yeah. I would also always say you should get it because it's so important for this team fight. There's nothing that I could get that is best, but who knows? Radiant's bottom tower's got problems. They keep grouping up, moving around the map,
good ancient stack.
Getting objectives. Now they are going bottom. Tide Hunter goes in with his blink. He has his blink already. That is good. That will help them. Their supports are still way behind, though. That's gonna hurt them.
Yeah.
And here they go again. They group up as five. They take a tower.
No, there's, I haven't taken it yet.
There's a defusal blade on the Phantom Lancer also now.
Ooh, that's a big power spike.
Yeah, let's see what happens. Oscar goes in. There's
in.
A chrono that catches two completely outside of it.
Ooh.
It's enough to stop them though, apparently.
Freeman Ravage.
And there was a Templar.
Yeah, Piglex is gonna die. That's about it, I think. Tidehunter's gonna die as well.
That ward just catches a leech, and it's a 3-for-1.
Yeah.
Unless they make something
just
happen.
Just, you know, good sustain.
Yeah, this is gonna be over quickly, because with this Vlad's Void also, their push is really strong. And there's the eggs on the Queen's
Absolutely.
Main. So if they keep doing this,
the Chronosphere coming out from Chell was really good.
Yeah, it catched both.
Like that Chronosphere, it didn't catch
behind
the Huskar, but it isolated him.
Yeah,
and
exactly.
So the Huskar just died, and there was no initiation.
Yeah, and the others just sat there. Exactly. It's a very good. This Void is going really well, and now it has the blink also. Oh my God, the farm. The farm coming out of this offlane Void. Yeah, it's 5-0-6, and the Queen of Pain also. 5-0-2, we have a 2-0 puss, so yeah. Looking pretty dim if they keep doing what they are doing. I would say for a pack, the best plan here would be maybe to try and play the aggressive and go on with smokes and things like that. Because if they keep being on the defensive, they will lose the game. They don't have enough
right. Absolutely.
Defense power, I would say. And they have very aggressive heroes on the form of Askar and Templar Assassin. Yeah, but this...
Right, you know, 50 seconds... Yeah, 50 seconds in, once you get Ravage back up, 40 seconds now. You know, get a smoke, rotate, try to get a pick off on one of these big high-value cores.
Yeah.
And get a pick off on the Phantom Lancer, get a pick off on the Queen of Pain. You know, you're somewhat back into it. They might not need... Nope. Blinks out.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, they need to be smart about this, though, because she has blink, so the only way they will catch her out is if they have... Yeah, it's it's almost impossible, because the Witch Doctor and the Ogre alone might not be enough. You would have to have Tidehunter to help with that. Is Ravage is gonna come off cooldown now, though?
Yeah, you need to commit Ravage.
Problem is, Rock and Roll has all their ultimates up as well. There's a Yasha coming out for the Phantom Lancer, and they are smoked, and they are going as five. Guess for what they are going. They are going for the last outer tower as five again.
Yeah, Phantom Lancer showing in the mid lane, maybe acting as bait as the rest of Rock and Roll wrap around.
Yeah, they are going for the Tide Hunter.
Phantom Lancer, good blink initiation from Hatong, draining all of the mana, and boom.
Hello,
ooh,
the dead.
Finger and Scream committed. That was a miscommunication.
Yeah, a bit of an overkill, but still. It's the most important target, because without that Ravage, they can't do anything to defend. If they commit their heroes, they're gonna
be
die.
Up to high ground, though.
Yeah, I don't think it's gonna be high ground, probably. Not sure, though. This Templar Assassin is still very behind. She has only her Mithril Hammer now. She doesn't do that all that much, considering they're all fairly tanky now. The Leech even has is going for the mech. He has his headdress and his buckler. Yeah, they are pushing a bit. Okay, they are going on Sen now.
Wow, they're just going straight in onto Scene. Scream of Pain up already because of the Aghanim Scepter. Void going
and
the
there's a beautiful
line, cleaning
chrono.
Up the Ogre Magi. Ravage comes out trying to save Khaleesi. Khaleesi's doing her best, but she's gonna go down.
Tidehunter, Soul Survivor.
And follow, maybe? Not even.
And with everyone dead, they can just push this tower and even maybe go for the barracks if they want. Because the problem is, they're actually at their peak and, well, Pack doesn't have anything. This Uskar is really underwhelming. He has his Mordision and the Helm, but is not doing enough and is being controlled. And there's a lot of magical damage flying around also. Too much for him to handle, I would say.
Yeah. Absolutely. I love the Arcane Boots pickup on the Lich this game, actually. It's just, it provides that little extra bit of sustain. But even if Pack and Aaron come all up and try to contest, they can just go again.
Yeah. Right. I agree. I totally agree. That's what they're
Finger
planning
of death
on.
Is back up.
They have just so much sustain that they can stay there.
Ooh,
okay, there was a good peek off.
The lion, that was not a good idea. Huskar going in onto the void. He's gonna die as well. 33 going in, trying to do her best.
Come back, boys.
Clean up the ogre. Yes. Gonna clean up the witch doctor as well. 33 is doing a monster amount of damage right now. Gonna take out Khaleesi as well, and she is gonna go down though. So that is a huge gold swing. 1,000 gold going to the Phantom Assassin. Templar Assassin. Yeah.
You wish you had a Phantom Assassin.
And that's gonna
game.
Give her enough gold for her Deso.
Yeah, that's true. This was really good from the from Pack anyway. They managed to hold on to the game that could have ended here, and they only lost their barracks, which is still recoverable.
Well, let's be clear here. Rock and Roll kind of overstayed their welcome and got a little aggressive.
Yeah.
There's no reason for that team fight to happen.
Yeah, I agree. They still lost. Also, Pac still lost their Uskar with this. He's sitting at no money right now, so that will hurt. He's not a good hero to be playing from behind.
Like
and... Sorry, go ahead.
No, I just wanted to say, you know, that Phantom Lancer did kind of 1v5 their team and take three people down with him, so...
Yeah, Phantom Lancer things. I'm very curious about this Desolator on the Queen of Pain, though, to be honest.
I hadn't even noticed that.
Yeah, they usually don't go for right-click items unless you have another kind of buff. Like, if you go for AC, then you get something else. But Desolator is not a very common pick-off, and she has the Axe, which makes me wonder. You would expect something like Sight, what else can she get for damage? Octarine Core. This game,
that's
she doesn't...
Orchid, I was thinking.
Orchid
into Bloodthorn.
Orchid into Bloodthorn, that would be amazing also. Yeah, I'm not exactly seeing the Dezo utility here. But I guess the Uskar doesn't really have that much armor, I guess. If she blows up his armor, then that would help. But against who? Against the Phantom Monster? I don't know. I don't know what she was thinking.
I think it is against the Huskar. Absolutely. Huskar does start off with a low armor. And so
I guess that's what she was thinking of. This Phantom Lancer is also very much ahead with his Mantanel. Okay, there's the late Ravage.
Oh! Ravage coming in, kills the item. Queen of Pain does pick it up though. Lisi going down.
Perfect chrono
JSPN
again.
JSPN stopped to kill the item. What did she end up killing? That's actually my question.
I also didn't notice, to be honest.
Queen of Pain, oh, that Phantom, that Templar Assassin starts to do a lot of damage, actually.
Yeah, now she is doing
takes
a lot of damage.
Aegis from the Queen of Pain,
Oh no, they have no vision again, because where are the supports? They chased this Ogre Magi and they got him. But Sin is still surviving this.
Yeah.
Terrible. How do we say her name, by the way? Is it Sin or Sen? I would say Sin, because two E's, but
Sin.
Who knows?
It's two E's.
Yeah. Well, they are pretty much going on in again. What can they do to stop this Phantom Monster now is
no
the question. Lich has his ulti up, Queen of Pain ulti up. There's no Ravage for 70 seconds. This Uskar still has nothing.
They don't have Ravage, they can just go take this.
If they want, they can rotate bottom and take everything. Although the lane is not pushed enough yet, I would say. Dire's bottom tower is Okay. Teen is going aggressive and they're backing off. Sacking the leech maybe. Oh god, he managed to use his frost chain frost before he was dead, so there goes the Oscar again and the witch doctor. Double kill for Chao, who is doing amazing this game, and Ibex coming out from pack. Ascar and Temper are back in the fray. Okay, this Queen of Pain is gonna die at least. These buybacks are not enough though.
How do they still not have vision?
Yeah, and this Ascar is dead again. He's been sitting in the same network for, what, 10 minutes now? He's after the Witch Doctor and the Ogre Magi. Everyone else, including the supports of Rock and Roll, are ahead of him. I think this game is pretty much safe to say will be over soon. Yeah, I don't want to call it yet though.
Rock and Roll just had. Oh. Am I in?
And there's Chrono again. Shell is going on.
Everybody else.
Yeah. Witch Doctor tries to use his ulti. There's Ravage finally. Phantom Lancer is still working on those barracks after trying to kill the Templar Assassin that always escapes because they don't have vision for her. But it's useless because...
Oh, they have a sentry ward now.
Yeah, the Leech just placed one now. And Megas.
Finally.
These Fistlets went for the Manta style, which was a very good pick-off in this case. Can just take everything off. And GG is called. They know they can't do anything. Rock and Roll just steam all over them. The Ascar didn't matter because although he farmed, it couldn't do anything. The supports didn't rotate. In general, I think they played a bit passive, and that's kind of can explain. The game is not ending though, so I'm guessing they are not clicking something that they should because GG was called. Not exactly
GG
sure.
GG was totally called.
How does this work in this kind of tournament? Isn't it supposed to end now? No, they are going ham, okay.
Oh, I guess it's not ending. Right, yeah, Pack Kadarin's just going ham at this point, so...
Yeah, it's all in, but there's nothing that they can do, because they're gonna be, GG called again? Ancient under attack by
GG
the...
GG called again.
Mega Creeps. I think they're desperately trying to say, take us out of this game, and they
there
did it!
Go.
There we go, Rock and Roll takes his first one, 33-11. Who's the MVP of this game, Safe?
I think the Void, definitely.
Definitely the Void,
Void
I agree.
Got his farm really well.
Amazing lane,
just
amazing Chronos.
Beautiful 2-3, 3-4-man Chronospheres. Just ridiculously well positioning and well played on his part.
Yeah, I agree. Okay, guys, we'll be on for the next game soon, hopefully. For now, we will stop this stream and see what's up.